Mario versus Luigi. It's a good game, but you want to be just as good. Well, my friend, this video is the right one for you. I'll be going over MVL Online with all its mechanics and explain to you some of the tips and guides for being the best. As best as watching a YouTube video will get you anyway. So, hang on to your seat and we'll get into game modes. Before you can even start playing as Mario or Luigi, the host of the lobby will decide on the game settings, like how many stars need to be collected, how many lives do you have, how many coins to trigger a roulette. The basic things. There's generally four game modes of play that will result from their decisions. Winner takes all, deathmatch, time deathmatch, and marathon. Don't think of them as literal game modes, but as mindsets you need to have for each. First past the post, a game of being the first to have all the stars with lives not being the driving focus. You'll want to stay active as to collect the stars and avoid getting your stars taken from you. This is probably the most common type of game you'll play, being it's what Mario vs. Luigi was designed for. Inside here is Time Attack, wherein the clock is what ends the game and the player who has the most stars wins. It might sound the same, it literally is the same, but I swear, that ticking clock, it does something to you. Deathmatch game consists of 1 to 2 lives and high star limits. While it might be fun to try and kill everyone, remember that the objective is just to stay alive. So, always remember, son,
dying is gay!
Time Deathmatch is what you get when you combine Deathmatch and Time Attack. In many aspects, it's a truer Deathmatch, as you're forced to play more aggressively as to get the stars, but with the ever-present threat of death ringing over you. Risk assessment is the key, choosing your life over the power star. It's thrilling from start to end. And lastly is the marathon game, which is probably the result of a poorly set up deathmatch as a result of choosing pipes, but a true marathon game isn't one that lives don't matter, there's no time limits, and there's a reasonable amount of big stars to collect. Your objective is to have the lead, but not so much of a lead as to other players getting the Starman in their roulettes. Survival is like deathmatch, but with more lives. Power-ups. The Fire Flower. It's tried and true and it can have great offensive capability in combat and collecting the stars. It tends to lend itself best in advantageous positioning on high places. You can even do combos with it, but it struggles against propeller foes, foes who can pick at you like a little mosquito. I believe that the only limit to this power-up is your own skill, so make the best of it and become the best with it. My advice to you for this and the ice flower is to have the highest ground possible, with easy escape vectors, of course. There's a bug where you can shoot fireballs while skidding, but remember the direction they shoot is tied to the direction Mario is still facing during that animation. Look no more, for to this is the killer part of the Fire Flower. It gets the funny kills, but it doesn't lend itself very well to multiple opponents, as you need to capitalize on your freezes to be effective, which is inherently risky to do. Not really the best option if you're seriously pressed for time. The ice balls are also more limited in range than the fireballs. However, you can catch landings with them. The best usage for these are in getaways, against a propeller, and of course murder. Frozen opponents can be thrown or ground pounded. If you decide to throw them, they'll slide until they break on collision and lose a star, or after their frozen timer ends and lose nothing. You can avoid being picked up by standing under a map geometry, such as hard blocks, question blocks, and whatnot, but I can't guarantee that you still won't be picked up and thrown, as the Unity Spaghetti Monster always finds a way. Shell. The shell sees its best play as area denial small spaces, but with a slower speed than running, no triple jumps, and no way to follow up on attacks like collecting stars from enemies, or barely a way to follow up, as well as being riskier in bad positions and being predictable in its movement, it tends to lend itself generally to being a weak option. Now, don't get me wrong, the shell itself isn't weak, like to weaken enemies with good power-ups or just killing them, but someone who's wise to your tricks can trounce you. The most useful benefit of the shell is its ice resistance. You don't get frozen, but if you can play your cards right, you can take away their power. Even those crouching who have the shell, which wasn't part of the original. Shell skipping. You can shell skip by basically b-hopping with the shell, but instead of not holding forward down, you don't hold down the gas, which is to say the run button. Here's Grape doing it in action. She's far more skilled in this than what I am. Propeller. This power-up excels at area denial of open spaces. as it forces people to retreat or take cover from you, lest they want to lose one of their power stars. When you trade for projectiles, you well make up for with aggression, though a pro may be able to avoid your barrage as your attacks are choreographed. If you're both using the propeller, then your aim is to get much higher than them. So high. Also, I got my second sniping. Unlike in TF2, where it's frowned upon, in this game it can work to your benefit. Though, make sure not to try and second snipe from below. Then you'd be the stupid one. You may also use this power to avoid players altogether if you feel like it. And when you do get hit and lose a star, you can instantly get it back in a spin. If you're facing off against the propeller, take cover under unbreakable map geometry, like with ice, or you can just, you know, run away. Don't be like Hitler over here making himself easy pickings, be like Crispy Cat instead. I think we can both agree that being anything other than a Führer is desirable. Mini Mushroom, the weakest power-up in the game. While you trade for mobility, for endurance you can make up for in absolutely no way. Yeah, being able to get killed by pretty much anything doesn't lend itself to too many wins, so avoid Annoyed and skip this one. Starman. You already know what the Starman is, but an epic thing you can do with a star is a super jump. If you stop holding forward down for just like a sixth of a second before jumping, you can do the super jump. Thanks, Grape, for showing this technique, as well as shell skipping. Use this power up in conjunction with the fire to get the edge on your opponents, and outrun those roaring titans. Those guys, other Starmen, and stage hazards are your only real threat while in this state. Mega Mushrooms. Mega Mushrooms excel at large ambushes. As large of an ambush as seeing an earthquake and hearing the music is. You're like a Starman who's bigger and better. You're unrivaled by anything else except another Mega. But remember, when attacking you don't automatically collect the stars of downed foes, so still go after those. Mechanics. Big stars spawn around the map, and when collected, levels reset. If you have one in your hit, it'll fly from your back, so make sure you're facing the right way if you want to keep them. The player with the most stars has the most power in the game, in first past the post, and especially in time attack. They get to be ones to call their own shots. My advice to you is to attack and be conscious of both you and your opponent's final star position. One last thing to note for games with timers. You know how I mentioned that the timer's what ends the game? Well, sometimes it just doesn't. Or have no draws, the game waits for someone to gain a lead before calling a victor. What, do you think I was just going to call out the timer and how it fails to give someone the win sometimes? Or the host can stop the game and it ends in a draw too, meaning having no draws isn't something iPod Touch needs to avoid? The answer would be yes. The item roulette. While the host often sets the amount of coins to trigger it to 1, the default is actually 8. It's like Mario Kart and which items you'll get. Fontrons get mushrooms and mini mushrooms, while those 5 to 10 stars behind, they get stars and mega mushrooms. In something like Deathmatch or Survival, you'll want to avoid the stars anyways, because that's not the game you're playing here. But you don't want to give others a chance to get items that can kill you. Ground Pounds. They let you stop on a dime, and if one connects with the player, up to 3 stars will be dispensed from them. If you have fast fingers, you can do air stalls to confuse your opponents. Wall Jumps. They let you start on a dime and can be helpful in mix-ups, whatever those are. Misplace some pipes, or in evading mega opponents. Triple Jumps. You press jump 3 times and at a third jump you jump higher, but not stay bigger or live forever. Remember that the second jump isn't any larger than the first, and like I've previously stated, these are impossible to do with the shell. But also, don't think you can't make that jump, because it is possible. But also, slopes. By pressing down on them, or ground pounding on them, you initiate a slide. You can be hot with slopes by sliding, and then crouch jumping. Just remember not to hold forward down, as that'll cap your speed back to running. Crouch jumping is preferable to triple jumping, as you won't be halted after your third jump. Just like how uncapped speeds were in the original, the ends of mushrooms are also slopes you can abuse. These are actually intentional changes, believe it or not. Spinblocks spin you upwards in the air, and you can press down to go into a drill and strike someone for 3 of their stars. This block has some special interactions with power-ups, like you can propeller spin from a spin, or you can get double speed with the Mega Mushroom. The top 2 facts you might not know about the spin block that could be useful is that you can't spin while carrying something, and also they work like slopes in that you can maintain your speed by not pressing forward down after jumping. This won't be patched because this is also the behavior in the original game. I knew that myself. And changeability frames. Before I go any further, I have to explain that goes both ways. Shell, Mega Mushroom, Stomps, Ice, whatever it is, if they have frames or you have frames, there won't be any interaction. That's the dual-sided nature of intangibility. And I think that's the most important thing to understand. Once you do understand it, you can play to its strengths and around its limitations. I think Sun Tzu best describes what you can do with this knowledge. Now I've explained the rule, here's the exceptions. And another thing though, is that they're stun and tumble. You get stunned by fireballs and whatnot, and enter tumble from being jumped on. You're not fully invincible when stunned, as you can still get stomped on like a Koopa, and can still get hurt in shells even in tumble. Yeah, I know, that probably shouldn't happen, but it does. Bad guys. Bowser has come equipped with some baddies of his own. They can be killed with fire, ice, or the shell, and will drop a coin when killed, with listed exceptions. First up is the Goomba. If you jump on it, it won't drop its coin. That means ground pounds are fair game. Then there's the Koopa and Spiny. Ground pounding them will send them flying away from you. Except when the Spiny is face up, but come on, you already knew that. Holding them for too long will cause them to break free from you. They're okay for throwing at people, I guess. You can also use some pretty clever methods to get your hands on a throwable blue shell yourself. Next is the Piranha Plant. They're weird, as in, you have to be standing on the pipe in order to stop them from coming out. And like in any Mario game, don't trust them. I also almost forgot to mention the Bomb. Your attractive one, just throw it at the wall, like this. And then it'll bug out and be defused. In fact, you can do this with any enemy you can carry. Just so long as you're in the air, the enemy will die without hitch. Exclusive dice is Bill Nye the Science Guy. Global warming will not work on him, no matter how much the Earth is on f***ing fire. You can make with him what you do birdly, and stand on him for a short while before he falls off hard. There's no way to mug him for his change, but you can make a change by not smoking as many cigarettes, as he dies when there's so much smoke you can't even And the last thing to mention is that enemies will respawn on players when the star is collected. This is most frustrating with this Koopa in jungle. With all these Oopalas out of the way, now it's to the meat and potatoes of the video, the maps. With 10 different maps to choose from, what's not to love? The Plains, SMB1-1, whatever you call it, it's a pretty basic map. Avoid loitering around the pits and try and stand on the sky bridge, as well as this area with the question mark boxes. Maybe up here if things are hectic, or just run if someone's got the propeller. The reason I tell you to stand on these places is that stars generally end up here, and also positioning is a key in a game like this. But if it's just you and one other guy, the best thing to pretty much do on any map is just to run around collecting the stars. Maybe with propeller for evadability in case they get a superstar. You can also hide in pits if someone has a Mega Mushroom and they're haunting your tail. Here's the map in the level editor with all its intricacies. I hope this resource proves helpful to you. I'll keep a link to all these in the pinned comment. And this gray thing over here, that's a responsible hidden block in case the staircase gets destroyed. Bricks. Stars usually end up on the ceiling of the map, so it's never a bad idea to be up here with the propeller. A risky thing you can do and probably shouldn't is to make holes in the floor to send people to their deaths via eye shocks or just plain skill. You're able to do this by buffering a jump right before hitting a ground in a ground pound. If this interests you, you can practice it in a solo lobby. This map can do serviceably as a deathmatch map, as players tend to make mistakes and die, but is otherwise unrecommended for such play. Stay away from this one brick, as it tends to be broken by shells, and you'll die. Here's the map in the level editor. Pause now to examine. Ice. I don't have much to say about this map. The high grounds are generally passive, as fireballs don't connect with targets below, but the stars still do generally end up here, which is where you want to be, considering if there's company below. My recommendation to you is just to run around the map and use a spin block glitch. If there's people with the Mega Mushrooms, stand under the ice structures, and not the propeller block, please. Here's the map in the level editor. Pause now to examine. Pipes. Pipes is probably the most level in this mode, but all you need to know is that this is objectively the best spot in the map to be, as you have fast access to 5 of the 8 stars, it's well defended and easy to retreat from, and it's the high ground. If players aren't coming to you, then you'll have to come to them. But there's also a good spot up here for avoiding megas, as well as bullying, of course. Don't ever leave it if there's a mega roaming about. But if you don't like listening to my advice or have the shell, you can camp here in the foyer where the players are, or in this area where the stars are, 3 of them. Here's the map in the love letter. It altered the indents above the pipes a little bit, and gave the level a roof. But these can work to your benefit. Let me explain. If the game has a timer and you're feeling a bit cheeky, you can gain the lead and camp in one of the indents until the timer runs out. You're practically betting on having more stars than what anyone else could possibly attain. If you have Mini or Propeller, you can get up here for your wild prize of 4 coins, though if you're big and skilled enough, you don't need those. Just remember that players below will get your roulette item, so plan accordingly. Castle. It's not a fortress. My eyes and ears don't deceive me. Shell excels in this level. Why? Because every few seconds you get trapped with another hapless loser. Why not kill them with the precious time you have together? That sounds lovely, doesn't it? So make it happen, and snowgrave them into this pit if you need to. If there's multiple players, they're gonna beat each other up when the ceiling comes down and lose all their stars. Maybe some of them will appear in this advantage spot, so if you're planning on waiting out the clock while everyone else is still alive, best give this a big shot. But make sure you become big yourself and have power-ups, because bombs can be still lodged here by the power of the ceiling. Here's the map and the level editor. I'm not sure if it's intentional or not, but they fixed these two tile bugs from the original, which I thought was nice. Now moving on to custom levels, which is why I installed Unity to see these in the first place. Jungle.
The jungle.
What's other to say than the ice flowers what Microsoft excels? That's all you really need to know about this map 11, which has two names. Avoid the pits if you don't have the ice, and you'll be fine. Also be wary of the pits at the start of the game, that you might be trampled for being directly inside someone else. If you need a place to camp, it's here, because you might hit people jumping towards you into the poison water. If someone's hot on your tail with the propeller, you can just run away and seek shelter here. Here's the map and the level editor. You can see that the stars are more so to the right side, and use that knowledge as you will. The sky. Once you get the propeller, you can comfortably stand up past the clouds and collect the taxes of the poor souls below. Or with Fireflower, that can work too. If someone's got the propeller and pestering you, you can stand here. At the start of the game, you might be tempted to go for these coins here to get an item, but be wary of thieves. Consider your options like maybe going for this mushroom, or these pipe coins, or the star. The mushroom area is disadvantaged, more so than usual because there are slippery slopes that'll kill you. Stand about here or here if you want to snowgrave people, or here if you want others to do your bidding. Stand here if there's monsters nearby, unless someone else is already there with a star. An alternate place to retreat to is here, as it's harder for the mega guys to get up here, and they'll probably go after someone else after failing to get you. And there's this evil spot also that I found while making this. If they do end up there, you can go around in a circle and start the process all over again for them. Here's the map in the level art. Lots now to examine. Volcano. The top side of this citadel of a map is a safer place to be. If you're waiting for something to happen, stand up here. Or here if someone's got the propeller. Let the stars spawn at the bottom, so if you're after those, go there and try and stay safe while you're at it. Maybe get an ice flower to murder people too. If you're trying not to be turned into frozen chicken, then maybe stand under the question blocks. It's not guaranteed with anything related to ice, but it's worth the shot. Also, don't do this with the shell. It's okay to take things slow. It's also okay to have fun sometimes, alright? Here's the map and the level letter. Pause now to examine. I promise I'm not hiding any secrets from you.
Bonus ducks!
The killer areas to be are by the red box machines outside the 7-Eleven. There is no 7-Eleven, but the blue area is the closest thing. Try to snowgrave people, make sure to remove these bricks as it makes it easier to slide them in there. Positions of power are generally on top of the pyramids of this level, so try and be there. Also try to invade the guys with the ice powers. It's like Castle, but weaker. Yes, look at this Family Guy funny moment number 143. Here's the map in the level area. It never registered to me before making this video that there was two separate red boxes. Desert. Onto our delicious last course is the Layer Cake Desert, but let me tell you, friend, that the cake is a lie and Shrek is disappointed. What you get in return is a map where you can be zooming and boinging past everyone, and even dinging all with the power of the slopes. You can try and use this one as a start to get the mushroom before anyone else. Use them to get stars around the map. Staying on top of the semi-solid platforms is fine if you want to be passive or just get stars from tax collecting. If someone's giving you air troubles, you want to tip the scales back in your favor. Better. Stand between the semi-solid platforms. Here's the map and the level layer. Pause now to examine. Controls. Here are the controls I use. That is Q as my second up as to be able to do fast ground pounds. game sense. Now that you know everything, how do you win? And the answer to that is, I don't know. But I have some words of advice I couldn't fit anywhere else, so here they are. The map loops around. I know that's a bit obvious, but it's been pointed out to me that it's a bit counterintuitive to run away from the star in the line. Here's an extreme example. Also, players exist on this line too, and if you see an arrow near yours on the Starline Express, but you don't see anyone, someone's either above or below you, and they might even be planning an ambush on you. So, avoid taking one to the knee and be aware of your surroundings. Speaking of being aware of your surroundings, do you know star spawning is deterministic? They go through all the places in the map one by one, and will not spawn within a certain radius around players. Maybe not
this big.
Think of all the system as being a big checklist the game makes of where to put stars. It goes through all the items one by one, and skips a star from
pesky plumbers
there. Also, as this is the grab back section, you know in Sky how I mentioned stealing? Well, you can do that on any map on any time. Let me explain. You can actually do that on any map at any time. It's that simple. If you see an item or know someone's gonna get an item, take it. It's yours, my friend. Also, player spawning in, they want to power up as fast as possible. What do you do? You take it. Shouldn't you have what's rightfully yours? You're getting stronger, yes. Oh, where was I? Oh yeah, go after players without power-ups. Preferably ones you've stolen from after they've spawned. They'll never see it coming. Consider giving spectating a shot. Go see the pro and what methods they're using. Or you can study games I've played in the playlist in the description below and see how I try and win. If not, this video was helpful, please share it with a few of your folks. I've been RST, and Godspeed Wagon to y'all. Now for cutoff prevention.
Yeah, see.